The following program is rated mature. It may contain strong, coarse language, violence, and other mature content not appropriate for children under 17. The views expressed in this program may not represent those of this cable station or its employees.
It's 9 o'clock on a Friday night, so grab a seat and you just might see something really great. You've got the time, it's not too late to watch a show that will give you laughs and chills and thrills. There's nothing that they haven't tried, cause everything tastes great when it's deep fried. So lock your doors and sit right down, there is no better place to go. It's time for the Not So Late Show.
Hi. Hey, Jason's now live on our Facebook thingy.
Nope, I'm live on my page.
Oh.
I got more people. But you can go live for our page.
I could, but I'd rather just watch
it. So I'm
this.
Not doing either of the two.
Are you on Wi-Fi?
Me?
No, it doesn't work here because we still don't have Optimum's Wi-Fi in this building.
Well, we're at 12 gigs.
Are we?
Yes.
Out of how many?
Cool.
That's my bad.
Well, look who's going to pay for it then.
Yeah.
Wait, how many gigs do you guys have?
16.
When's your...
It won't take 4 gigs to live broadcast this whole thing.
What?
Up higher and up. Aim it straight up. You know how this works.
Sorry, what's that?
Make believe you know what you're doing.
When's your bill expire?
8 days.
So you guys can't live off of 4 gigs.
And for 8 days?
For 8
days. No, we definitely.
I've been traveling a lot this past month.
And whose fault is that?
Days? I don't know. Really, how it's been going? I don't know, maybe. Who knows?
Your company should buy you a cell phone.
I do not disagree with that. With how much I use it for work, yes, totally.
However, he would blow right through the data cap within.
Actually,
like,
you know what? You know what? If we go over, I'm expensing the data because I've legitimately used like 10 of these gigs for work.
Expenses?
Yes. Anyways.
Protector
at all. Well, it's not. No, I meant through work I can get reimbursed.
Oh, anyways, yes. Okay. Well, yay for still.
That too. So, yeah. Mm. Welcome back. You've been gone for 2 weeks. Well, not gone, but.
1 week.
Well, you missed last week.
Missed last week, yeah.
So, 1 week to there, and then 1 week to the previous show. 2 weeks.
Screw you.
Anyways, what you been up to? What you doing? How are you?
Lot of actual work.
Boring.
I made a mistake.
Just one?
Well.
Was it working
much? The one I'm going to tell you about.
Okay.
For my sister's birthday gift.
Remember, parole.
Parole.
I'll speak positively at your
hearing. Never mind. Anyways.
Don't worry.
Well, I said don't incriminate yourself since you're on parole.
No. That's only in New Mexico.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That's good.
And now that I've crossed the state borders,
right.
Which I don't know if I should have.
Details.
But I'm back.
Extradition.
No, extradition from the
It's United extra?
States. So, anyways, I...
Usually it's just regular edition.
I gave my sister a birthday gift, which
what
was...
What are you doing? No, it's pointing down instead of up.
Was the box? I think the box might be muted, too. Is it muted?
Here, let's try that. See if that works a lot better.
And let's try this, too.
Point it up.
I'm just going to do this just like Brad.
Isn't live TV great?
Yep.
There we go. We haven't been doing this for 10 years.
Even if we taped this, actually, we would still do that. Anyways.
Yeah,
that's true, too.
Yeah.
So, I didn't buy her anything.
Yeah?
I said I would give you a day's worth of labor.
Oh.
Ooh.
Yep.
Your time is valuable, you know.
Really valuable.
Yeah.
So I
turned into a week of work.
I fixed her gut. I fixed her gutters in two spots.
Okay.
Which wasn't that big. She had to take a bunch of the nails out and put new screws into the wood.
Sure.
New screwed her wood.
Then I got up on the roof, fixed a little bit of the flashing that was around her chimney.
Okay.
And took a.
How many times have I told you not to flash the neighbors?
Well, you know.
Serious.
If they're not my neighbors, they're her neighbors.
Oh, okay.
Well, then it's fine.
And then I cleaned out all the gutters.
Uh-huh.
She had a flower box in the front of her house, which I figured would be nice and easy.
Yep.
It's above her garage, so you need a ladder for it. No big deal.
Okay.
Take out the plastic liner, throw the dirt down there, and it's really light, nice and easy. No, the person who put it in there did not put a plastic liner in there. They just took mossy dirt and threw it in there. So it was all melded in there. So I had to take the whole thing off, which it was a bitch to do.
Huh?
And by the way, she needed her
You don't sound happy about this.
No.
Okay.
Also, she needed a new front door.
Shut the front door.
No, we couldn't. We, she, oh.
You know, you could have shimmed the lock, or shimmed the hinges.
No. This was my sister. She wanted a new front door.
Haram. The whole this is people who are like, I have a virus. I need a new computer.
The whole top.
She's one of those people,
yes.
Isn't she?
All right. The whole top was rotted out, too. So
someone at home's like, what's wrong with that? And I'm going to go, you're an idiot. Anyways.
So, fixed her entire front door. Now, you think... Now, how long do you think that took? Bear in mind, it was me, and my dad was helping me with...
Replacing the hinges, too?
No, the whole door, the frame, everything.
Oh, the whole frame?
Yeah.
Oh, a couple hours at least.
Oh, I was thinking
with
that, like,
with all the other work. I got there at 9 o'clock.
Oh, you probably left at
10, yeah, yeah. 10, 11.
I got home at 8 p.m.
Okay. That's not horrible.
Not bad. Good work.
Guess when
not
I
great,
ate.
But not horrible.
What?
Guess when I ate.
The next day?
No, I ate at 7:30.
P.M.?
Yes. You want to know what my sister said to me?
What?
Or, well, said two people.
Right.
No, they didn't want to finish the work before they ate. No, really, you're making burgers. I can hold that in one hand and a hammer in the other hand. I'm perfectly fine doing that. I had never been so sore in my life.
And now you have disowned your sister.
Mainly because of one reason. Cardboard beat the piss out of my arm. This was all black and blue going down here.
Was it really?
Yeah.
Well, that doesn't sound like
that's the worst injury I got out of the whole deal.
Well, you should try harder next time.
That I throw my back.
Ouch.
No.
Mm. Don't do that.
No.
From lifting up the door?
No, it was from actually the roof.
Oh, the roof?
Yeah, when I got up on the roof.
Was
the
it
roof?
On fire?
No.
Oh, good.
It was really hot, though. I put my hand on it.
So it felt like it was on fire.
Yes.
Gotcha.
No, it was funny because my dad was trying to put together the door, and I was just taking a quick break, a water break.
Uh-huh.
And I went down there, and I'm like...
Quit drinking water, pussy!
Yeah.
I met your dad.
I looked at it, and I said, Dad, I don't think those hinges are in the right spot. Before we drill the holes, we might want to... He's like, nah, we should drill the holes. I'm like, no, just look at it.
Uh-huh.
Which way is it going to open?
Let's just step back.
Right.
Take a minute. And he looks at it, he's like, shit, Pat, these are on the wrong way. Like, yeah, I know.
The hell you say?
Flip it over.
Yep.
Then my sister comes out, and she's like, those are on the wrong way. You got to put them over there. And he's like, no, they're right. He's like, thank God they're right now. So that was my...
Ah, but your sister never would have known the difference, so you could have just said, yep, you're right. And then you could have just blamed it on her, be like, you said that was right, so...
Front door opens outwards, enjoy.
No, it's solid now.
Yes.
Well,
most front doors are, yes.
Then when then at Brittany's house,
uh-huh.
I got to fix a bunch more stuff.
Okay. Oh, good. Brittany, I bet you were...
Over this week.
And that wasn't even a gift. That was demanded.
Yes.
Hey, guess what you're doing this weekend? Sleeping in and playing video games? No!
Guess who wants a new deck?
Deck?
Oh, yeah, a new deck. Speaking of decks.
Are you sure she just doesn't have a slur?
I wish. Wait, I don't want a new one.
I think she was trying to tell you something. Anyway.
Damn it!
Wanted a deck.
Speaking of decks.
What if she wanted a bigger deck?
My neighbor, who's got a huge deck.
Oh, your neighbor has a huge deck.
Yeah, wraps around his entire back of his house.
She has deck envy.
How big is your deck?
It's average.
It's an average size deck?
Yeah. Oh. A porch, really. So, you know that Christmas rhyme, you know.
Do you cover the deck, you know, sometimes?
Well, for protection sometimes,
yeah. Sometimes, yeah.
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 From, like, storms. Yeah,
from moisture. Yeah. Moisture will kill your deck.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes.
Too much moisture? Pfft.
Yes. It
blows up and gets
God.
Fungus and...
Yeah.
Well, if you don't protect it, you get rot.
Yeah.
That's bad.
Yeah, then it'll either smell, be slippery. And,
yeah, that's no good.
Yeah.
No.
But anyways...
Then all of a sudden someone wants to replace your deck?
You know that Christmas story where, like...
It's not an easy thing to do.
No. I'm trying to move on.
I'm not.
I know. you know, like, when, like, Santa Claus lands on the roof of that, in that nursery, in that rhyme where, like, a rose such a clatter type of thing?
Uh-huh.
I finally heard what that sounds like.
Okay.
Sounds like my neighbor having the feet of his ladder kick out and fall straight down and break three ribs.
Oh! So, like, the ladder collapsed?
No, the bottom legs kicked out. No, kicked out that way. And it just went...
Ooh.
And he had a nice noggin bump. So we're assuming he went onto the deck and then fell down onto it.
Oh.
So and this is a solid 20 feet up.
He's lucky
that's all that happened.
Right.
Because if he landed the wrong way or fell backwards, could be dead skin.
I mean, if you hit the deck too hard, there will be lots of pain involved.
Oh yeah.
Well, it could be rough sometimes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Nobody likes it rough.
No.
They might say they like it rough, but they don't like it rough.
No,
no. Like nice and smooth. You know. Like a bronzed deck.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Yeah. See, someone slips and hurt themselves on the deck.
That's why you need protection.
Yes.
Truth.
You need to baby-proof the deck.
Yes.
No sharp edges.
Yes. Ruining the metaphor, but all right!
No, baby-proofing your deck is a very wise thing.
I don't know in what circumstance your deck would have hard edges.
Well, some royalty has sharp edges.
Mm.
Princes, maybe.
Too soon.
Right.
Not that prince.
Well, you didn't say Albert. Not that prince. Oh.
Yes. Got it.
Our Prince Albert or your Prince Albert?
My Prince Albert.
Ah. Might want to have that checked.
Yes. Hmm. Anyways.
Just for factual accuracy.
Now I'm trying to move on.
You wanted this.
You opened it.
Oh.
You need to enjoy this can of decks.
I'm going nowhere near your deck.
Oh, you've been on my deck.
I hear that a lot.
No. What?
What?
No one wants to go near my deck.
Yeah.
I like your deck. I go on your deck every 4th of July, at least.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Be careful.
Cook some burgers. And
yeah. You were telling everyone about your new deck last year. I don't know of anyone who's been on your deck yet, though.
Me either.
Yeah.
It's new, but it's very lonely.
Wait, yeah. You're talking about that's not a deck. The
my
outside
deck?
Where the fire pit is?
Yeah.
I've been out there.
Yeah.
I was there when it was dirt.
Yeah.
I was there when it was stone.
Yeah. Wait, it was stoned?
Brick.
Fuck.
But you haven't been there since he's had wood.
True.
Deck.
That's true.
Yeah.
You haven't had wood with me there.
No.
Brad's trying to start a friction fire here.
He's trying to start the fire pit.
Oh, yeah. It's a little far away for
that.
Yeah. Well, you have a trail of gasoline.
Yes.
Going back to Jay's deck. Which is more of a patio.
Yeah.
You know, if I had to be honest. You also have a deck and a patio.
I have a porch.
So you're a blessed man.
That's a porch.
Yeah.
That's a porch. It's covered.
Yeah, because it adheres to the house. It's covered the entire way.
Yeah.
You know, it's got column support. Yeah, it's definitely a porch.
That's a porch.
Yeah.
You have no deck.
I know.
I'm sorry.
You'll never eat the ladies if you don't have a good deck.
That's all right.
Yeah.
Neither does Brad.
We have a porch too. So sad.
It's all right. Mine was a fictional deck that I was making up anyway, so we're deckless.
Wow. None of us have a deck.
Brittany
Big, small,
has a
or
deck.
Other.
Yeah.
So Brittany has a bigger deck than the rest of us?
Yeah.
Wow.
But it needs work. I got to fix the deck.
This explains so much. Anyway.
It really does.
Yeah.
Wow.
Well, at least we know who has the deck in your family.
I hope your phone's waterproof.
No.
Anyway, moving on.
Looked at houses, too.
Did you?
I look at houses every day.
Me, too, when I drive to work.
Yeah.
But I looked at ones where I might live in them.
Oh, no, that's
Do the
less...
people know?
No.
You! I want to live in your house now.
What?
See, it's the thing. That's the thing. If you look at houses at night, they can't tell you're there.
Well, until they see your eyes glowing
back from the
window.
Yeah, when you peer in like this.
Yeah, it's when you close off the light from external.
But when you're just standing there.
Yeah.
Like that. Like, hold on. This is my.
Gotta figure this, a better this is, garden. This gnome. Is my. You this don't is, have a garden gnome.
This is my house shopping face. This is ours, just staring in, getting the ambiance.
The ambiance, yeah. You want to see how it feels to watch an entire show in that house. Because TV viewing's important.
Yeah, and like if I think I can get surround sound in the room.
And plus, you want to know if the windows steam up.
Yeah, exactly.
Because you know, summer you're doing laundry. Maybe you have a dryer vent hose that goes askew. You just want to make sure that if you're real close to that glass with your face right up against it, that it doesn't steam up.
Yeah, exactly. Because you need to. Do I have to winterize it?
No,
I don't want to.
Don't want to. Yeah.
No.
Yeah. So there you go.
Lovely.
Find anything?
Found some potentials.
Yeah.
Yeah. Actually below the price range now.
Really?
Yeah. I was shocked.
Free?
No.
Oh.
No.
I want a free house.
I do too.
Move to Detroit.
Although, one realtor tried to sell me on a nice house.
Okay.
Five acres of land.
That's a nice amount.
Yeah, I pulled up there. And he said, just imagine. And I'm like, okay.
Uh-oh, that's your problem. No,
I'm good enough.
You're like, abort, you know what, I'm good. You abort. Know, just no. Abort, abort, abort.
I was humoring him. I said, okay, I'm good at imagining.
Oh.
Imagine you didn't have a crack screen on your phone.
I don't.
Imagine.
Yeah, the dog hair.
Imagine.
The dog hair.
Very good. That's very good. Very good at imagining.
So, anyways.
Yes.
Imagine the potential that this has. I'm like, oh, okay, 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 okay. Be optimistic.
On the first I'm going to imagine you didn't say that. Let's continue.
On the first place you're showing me, I'm going to give you the credit that you're sandbagging me here, and there's going to be something decent around the corner.
Okay.
That was a lot. It was a plot of land.
But it was within your price range.
It was well below my price range.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, but he didn't show me any of that.
Imagine buying this and camping for 8 years until you can afford a house.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
5 acres of land, you can do a lot of camping.
Where was it?
It was in Simsbury.
That's a nice area.
Yeah, but the property taxes would have killed me on the property.
Just the property alone.
Yeah.
But their mill rate isn't...
What road was it on?
Yeah.
Route 10?
Okay.
Yeah. It was before the historical district all the way down there, but it was... it was just like a little off-street of Route 10, but...
Gotcha.
You know where.
Yeah.
Like, that's where it is. Yeah. Right off of 44 and 10.
Yep.
About a mile and a half down. And
nice. Sweet, sassy, molassy.
So anyways, busy week.
Yep. Well, that sounds good.
Haven't slept.
Oh, no. You should do that.
Overrated.
I think I have a problem sleeping.
Like, really?
I don't.
Okay.
I'll stay up to like 1 o'clock in the morning.
All right.
And I'll wake up at 4.
Sounds like a you problem.
Yeah.
Well, why? Why? Why?
No reason. Just I wake up and I'm like, I'm up.
Right.
So I didn't sleep that well tonight. No big deal. But that happens every night. You'd figure eventually I'd sleep well.
Mm-hmm.
No, I just walk around exhausted.
All right. That sounds like, sure it's not snoring or something?
No.
You're sure?
I mean, I know I snore, but...
Well, that can wake you up, you know.
No.
Sleep apnea.
No. Trust me, I don't have
Trust me, we know you snore.
Mm.
Oh, I know
we
you do.
We can hear you
I
two
snore.
Rooms away.
Yeah.
But...
Like, we're pretty sure, like... Is Brittany deafened one-eared by now, by the way?
No, we have a pretty loud fan in the room, so...
Okay. I'm your biggest fan.
What type of fan can drone out his snoring?
It's industrial.
Does it also run on Jet A fuel? Is it also called a turbine?
Maybe.
Remember Charlie and the Chocolate Factory?
Yeah.
That huge stainless steel fan?
Yeah.
One of those.
Yeah.
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 Where it could take off if it just became unhinged.
Right. Which is kind of the description for any of us. Anyways. All right.
Nailed it.
Jay, how about you? What'd you do this week?
I bought a house.
Yay! Congratulations!
Yeah.
You closed on it today, right?
I did.
All right.
I own a house now.
You fantastic.
Wait, you didn't own a house before?
No.
Wait.
No, I did.
What?
Now I own a house again.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
Huh?
Kind of cool.
I don't understand it.
Why?
What happened?
I bought a house.
Another one.
I never said another one. I just said I bought a house.
So you bought the house. You like? So you're moving?
No.
Yeah, I have to actually move out and move back in again. To my same house.
I'm confused. You bought it again.
I bought my house again.
Remortgaged.
I refinanced.
Yeah, that too.
So technically, I had to sell my house and then rebuy it for myself at a lower rate.
Well, congratulations.
Thanks.
He knocked 8 years off his mortgage.
Oh, really?
And 2 points of...
APR?
Yeah.
Oh.
4.7 to 2.8.
That's fancy.
That's good.
That's fancy pants right there.
Yeah.
Well done.
Thank you. That's about some of it.
But he still has a large mortgage payment, so he's still poor for another 15 years.
Yeah.
Compared to another 24.
Yeah.
20.
No, actually, you're right.
Listen, I know math. I do people's retirement funds.
Oh, God. And then the retirement crash of 2037
yeah.
will come.
You know how they, like, you listen to Planet Money sometimes, and they're all like, yeah, there was that big crash, or there was that big spike in the market, or that big drop in the
That's
market.
That's unexplainable.
It was unexplained, but we finally did our research, and we traced it all back to this one guy.
No. It's actuarial at that point. It's actuarial.
It's actuarially
that's,
your fault.
That's... Nah. No. Yeah, no.
Funny.
Misuse of the word, but still funny.
That's not true. My... Yes.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. You're not going to get Social Security, Brad.
Listen, that's
I was never waiting. I was never expecting that.
I was
that
never planning on that anyways.
Yeah.
Or a pension.
I was planning on that.
You were planning on that?
Yeah.
Yeah, do you know any of the stocks that you own? About that, I kind of put them in a little company that went called Exxon.
Do you...
Okay, I sold the stocks, and I had a really solid lead.
And then you shorted...
No, I went on... Okay, you remember, and I need to apologize about this, the stock money you gave me?
Yeah.
I really thought Enron was going to work out.
Penny stocks are the way to go. That's what the emails keep telling me.
Yeah, but I bought them before they were...
Penny? Right. Stocks. Now they're penny stocks.
Yeah.
See, you were ahead of the curve.
That's not the good curve you want to be.
Oh, that's what she said.
So,
anyways,
you have like 33 cents. I got it.
Sounds about right.
But he can pay you in cash now.
Nailed it.
What'd you do?
No, I can't. I can't liquidate it.
Yeah, fuck it.
I worked a lot.
Boring. Do something fun. Tell us about it.
Did I do anything fun this week?
No. Well, you had the X Games last week.
No. The week before that.
Two or three.
I had X Games.
Okay. I wasn't here last week for this. Did all the GoPros stay on the plane?
They all stayed on the plane.
Good. They all record.
Yeah.
So why do you say it like they all stayed on the plane? What happened?
Well, except for the ones we purposely chucked out.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
For insurance reasons, you never did that. Or you did do that and they broke.
Well, they did.
Yeah. Something tells me the deductible is more than
totally pancaked two GoPros.
Did you?
Yeah, pieces.
Oh,
like
pieces.
Listen, when a GoPro impacts the surface of the Earth at 130 miles an hour,
but you see those videos where they fall off the skydivers and they're perfectly fine.
They're not tied to something heavy,
right?
Yes. Well, they were tied to something heavy.
Oh.
And that heavy thing just went burr, 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 and then spit everywhere on Jay's laptop and made pieces.
I have a cover on my
cup. But we did get a couple to survive, which was good.
Good.
Yes, good.
You recognize the bottle?
Yeah, it's Mauna Kea.
Yes.
I think.
No.
Where's that?
Yep, nailed it.
Nope. Where's that?
The favoritest place in all the world, Mauna Kea.
We
I don't know why I'm
and then we were
using the SpongeBob
Yeah, but then she slapped me and threw me out. So,
is it time for tech news?
I give up. I don't know, is it?
It's time for tech news.
Oh, okay.
All right. Picking up where we left off, and I'm not even sure where that was.
At the beginning.
In the beginning.
Yeah.
Did you know?
I
might not.
You probably didn't. Did you know that there was never... ever an official
moon landing? I knew it.
No, there's one of those.
God damn it.
Ferris Bueller's Day Off soundtrack.
No.
Really?
With a lot of iconic songs in the movie, there was never an official soundtrack.
Huh.
But
until
now there's going until now.
All right.
It's not fully together.
I don't know where that came from.
I don't know. Is that a hair? Is that part of the shirt?
It's a hair.
It's a hair.
From what?
Definitely a hair.
I have no idea. Long and
space alien.
It's long and curly.
And white.
Moving along.
So, they're going to come out 30 years later with an official Ferris Bueller's Day Off soundtrack. The official track listing has not been released yet, but they're getting all the licensing together.
What do you mean
together.
The official track listing? No, it's just songs from the movie.
There's only so many songs in the movie.
Yeah, there's like 9 songs that you know, and then there's like all
the credit songs.
Ferris Bueller Gets Chased song.
Right.
And he's running through backyards and hello, ladies.
Right.
So all kinds of that stuff. So that is coming soon. Check your
That's
local...
Awesome.
iTunes or something.
Yeah, or your record shop.
Or your record...
Or
go to Strawberry and see...
Oh my gosh.
Then to FYE.
All of which are no longer with us.
Yes.
Anyway.
Is there a DVD store anywhere around?
Walmart.
Yeah, Walmart. Target.
Oh, Best Buy?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Technically.
Yeah.
Amazon.
Very convenient.
I just buy everything.
You and your physical media.
No, I get everything instant
stream
now.
Get
I gave
physical.
Up on... The only thing that sucks is the bonus features.
Oh.
Like, I want to get Deadpool on Blu-ray.
Right.
Just for the bonus features.
Just.
3D.
No.
Aw. See, that's the thing, though. Like, if you want to make your own Ferris Bueller soundtrack, if you have, like, Spotify or Amazon Music or any
Done.
Of those, you can already do that pretty easily. So, like, why have to ask?
I probably already have all the songs.
I'm almost positive you do.
Do. Do you remember Legends of the Hidden Temple?
Yes.
Yes!
Making a full feature movie.
What?
Yeah.
How?
Well, they're gonna.
Well, like so like the adventures
like
are
with
real.
Oh crap! Sure. What was the Olmec. Giant Olmec?
Yes.
I am Olmec.
Now you read the story. Now is that Olmec's name in there?
Yes.
What?
And
I remembered it without having a.
I remembered it
also okay. Without the story.
Well, as soon as you said it, I was like, yep, that's it.
But here's the cool part. Speaking of Olmec, the guy who originally voiced it
no.
is coming back.
Yes!
They found him. He's coming back. He's going to voice him again.
What has he been doing all these years?
Not being Olmec.
Praying
or
for
what is do they have the guy's name?
They did in the story. I just did a quick
I got to look this up because I want to go on IMDb. Like, what has Olmec
been up to?
Yeah. Well, like what has he
do
done?
Do you have a Power Ranger story in there?
No, I don't.
You guys remember Power Rangers, right?
D. Bradley Baker.
Yes, I knew it was a three-part name.
Oh, my God. He's done a ton of stuff.
Voice or actual?
Yeah, voice actor.
Can I see the face?
Yeah.
It's Olmec.
He's actually a really famous voice actor.
So, anyways.
Amy Jo Johnson.
You remember, yes.
My sweetheart.
So
I love her still.
You remember Zordon.
Oh, yeah.
Brad's going to like this. You know who's playing Zordon?
It's Bryan Cranston,
yes.
Isn't it? Yes. I saw that story. I'm like, I mean, I know the visual effects, they can distort it and everything.
Yeah.
But
so now they have Bryan Cranston and, what's her name?
As Walter White.
Elizabeth Banks. As Walter White, as Zordon.
Oh, that's cool.
So check this out. The guy who voiced Olmec, D. Bradley Baker, is like the voice of all the clone troopers in Star Wars Clone Wars series. He's Jake in the Neverland Pirates, American Dad. He's Klaus and Tony, Monopoly Hobo, Pillow Hands McGraw, Elf. So a whole bunch of guys there. Let's see what else we got. Adventure Time voice there. Some random Scooby-Doo stuff. The Powerpuff Girls. He was one of the voices in the Jungle Book.
Listen, if you have if you're a good voice actor,
he was
an
Ultimate Spider-Man.
All over the place.
SpongeBob movie, SpongeBob series, Gears of War. He was General Ram in Locust Drone A and Theron Guard and Berserker
Locust
voice.
Locust Drone A, we don't know.
No, but
he was
Ram.
A voice in Family Guy,
was
Phineas
General
and
Ram
Ferb.
The lieutenant.
Justice League, Gods and Monsters, The Lion King, Return of the Roar. Heroes of the Storm video game, Mr. Peabody and Sherman Show, Gravity Falls.
Wait, who is he in Heroes of the Storm?
Murky.
Oh, he's a Murloc.
Okay. I'm like, this is just like going back to like 2015.
If you're a voice actor and you're good, you get work constantly. Mark Hamill just did that for the longest time.
The Boondocks, Box
And the
Scrolls.
Funny part is, his voice is always the same. It's always the Joker.
Yeah, yes. Wow, so he was a voice in Destiny. My God, this guy's filmography is huge. They're going to have to pay a fortune. Seriously, I think he's like one of the top voice actors today. I remember seeing him in a documentary about voice actors.
I bet you he has a huge deck, too.
Probably.
Speaking of General Rom, that you just mentioned him voicing.
Uh-huh.
General Rom is now the newest character in Killer Instinct Season 3 on Xbox.
Hooray!
Playable character, and you can... So you can actually take General Rom and make him go against the Arbiter. Kind of cool.
I don't love Killer Instinct.
That's because you're boring.
Yeah.
Did you just slow clap me? You son of a bitch.
One more. Oh, that one hurt.
Yeah. Halo 5 news.
Ooh.
Coming
to a video game near
you. To a video game near you on June 29th.
What?
No.
What?
Don't release that. I just wanted to freak you out.
Okay. It's like pulling my finger. I don't know what you're doing.
You know when they say a butterfly flaps its wings, a tsunami is like on the other side of the planet?
Sure,
or something like that.
Yeah,
Jay's just causing earthquakes everywhere now.
Sure. In his pants.
Monica is now evacuating.
As is his asshole.
Are those...
Thanks, Mr. Hole.
Is Mauna Kea and Mauna Loa dormant?
Mauna Loa active, Mauna Kea dormant.
Okay. But does that mean that Mauna Kea cannot erupt?
No, it erupts every 3,000 years or so.
Okay.
Is Kilauea Iki actually part of Mauna Loa then?
No, it's part of Kilauea.
Oh.
Did you guys see that video of the volcano erupting? And like you can see.
Which one? Okay. There's about 80,000 of those on YouTube.
Okay, well, like where you, I don't know. I thought it was really cool because it didn't look like it was that far away.
Uh-huh.
But when everything kept going, like when it erupted, you can actually see the clouds. Just go.
Oh, that island and
yeah.
I know. Yes,
they were like brace for it.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was like, that was really cool.
And Patch Assad, welcome to the internet 2 years ago.
Yeah. Yay.
No,
did,
I just like.
Did you see all the?
I just
the
like sound waves.
Did you see the volcano? I think it's called like a Pokey Kitty.
No.
Sorry, inside joke.
It is an inside joke. But it's funny.
Yeah.
I hate you.
I know.
That's what you get for not knowing the South does. It is in the South Pacific.
Yes.
Anyway, getting back to it.
Uh-huh.
Halo 5 Guardians is now getting Firefight, which is
very
cool.
Yay! Excellent. Which is a fun mode, which is just more and more enemies coming at you wave after wave after wave after wave after wave.
Yes.
Oh, good.
It was originally introduced in Halo 3 ODST and Halo Reach.
Can you set, like, God mode again?
You can. I would assume you can, because they did in the last two.
Why don't they have the, the Flood one?
That is basically the Flood one.
Yeah, basically is.
The Flood one was in Gears of War.
No. The Flood one where, like, you slowly become
the water
the flood.
Just comes?
No, you like, people start becoming the Flood. You're in a group of, like, 16 people.
Oh, that's Zombie.
Yeah, the Zombies version of it.
I don't know.
They just never...
People at home are like, what?
Don't worry.
Huh?
Be geekier and you'll understand.
Anyways.
So they're getting Firefight.
And also, when that launches, they're actually making 4... live gold members entirely free the entire game of Halo 5 Guardians.
Wait, what?
From June 29th.
Wait, bury the lead.
Well, June 29th to July 5th.
Okay, so it's only like a week.
Right. Halo 5 Guardians entirely free.
All right, then.
After that?
That's enough time to beat the game and be like, all right, we're done.
You really can, too.
Yeah.
Have you played it?
No, but the games are exceedingly short.
We took our time.
We did.
Yeah.
Like, three months between playing. But
Well, no, when we were playing, like, looking around and stuff. Trust me, we could have hammered through it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
But also, if you want to buy it after that, they're going to give you 50% off.
Well, hot
the
damn.
The entire game, too.
Yay. And the crowd goes wild.
Yay.
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 So, speaking of Facebook live broadcasting.
Yes.
In a very shortly to be released YouTube update.
Which, by the way.
Update.
Sorry to interrupt, but...
No, you're not.
I know. Did you see the story about how, like, when they adjourned the House of Representatives in
the
United
sit-down
States,
strike?
Yeah, sit-down strike, and then... which, freaking idiots. But anyways. But, like, someone was, like, periscoping, like, the whole thing there.
I saw...
And C-SPAN was airing that instead. Somewhere there was a marketing manager at Facebook Live who committed suicide. Because he's like, Periscope! God damn it! You know? You know that happened.
Oh, I'm sure somewhere.
Yeah. Anyway, now, that was my only point.
Yeah, no, which is fine, but YouTube is now going to start live broadcasting as well.
Wait, I thought they already had that.
For only certain things. But now it's going to be for everything, because they said, holy shit, everyone's doing periscoping and doing Facebook live broadcasts, and we're sitting here with our thumb up our ass.
Yep,
with copyright infringements everywhere.
Yeah. So, click, click, click. Okay, time to get on this live broadcast thing, because... We're falling behind.
We're
Google, and we're, yeah.
Yeah.
And we don't like that. So, they're going to be coming out of it very shortly. Live YouTube.
Hooray.
Live tube. Oh, that can't lead to good things.
Which, actually, it'd be good for us, because then we can go on the Not So Late Show thing.
If only we had HD cameras.
Well, we do. There's one.
I know. But I'm looking at these $10,000 things, studio cameras.
Well, these are also about a decade old now.
At least.
These cameras?
I remember when they were put in.
HD was around then, too.
It was. But very expensive.
No, it wasn't.
It was.
It was the same price. Seriously, when they got these new cameras, the HD cameras were cheaper than SD. It was cheaper to buy HD cameras than SD. They had to make a conscious decision.
In 2006?
Yes.
I don't know if I can go along with that one.
It wasn't 2006. When they redid the studio, it was like 2011, right, Doug?
They didn't replace the cameras, though.
It's like 20... Yeah, they did.
I was still working here, and I left in 11.
Didn't they?
And it was well before I left, too.
Didn't they?
No, they didn't.
Didn't they?
No.
When you say redo the studio, you're not talking about all that stuff.
No, that, yeah, that.
The back.
Yeah.
The back.
Yeah.
That wasn't 2011.
When was it?
That was like a year and a half, 2 years ago.
Details.
Yeah.
Maybe 2 years ago.
Fair enough.
Yeah, you're
Why not HD cameras? God damn it. Anyways.
Because I think Miles at the time looked into it and said, No. He's like, you can get three brand new ones, or you can get one HD. That's not going to work.
One HD would have been fine.
I think you got a Black Magic Ascarin. Anyways, we're...
Black Magic Woman.
Yeah. Like, they have the studio. Fucking... Anyways.
I mean, out of the three of us, who do you think has the most experience in the studio? Me.
Yeah.
Idiots.
Of course.
Yeah.
If you happen to be going to Delhi or Mumbai...
Which is where I was going.
Which is where you're about to go.
I go to Delhi all the time.
No, 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 not that.
Good for you.
Mumbai.
I go to the Delhi and buy stuff all the time.
Good for you. But if you're in Delhi or Mumbai, I want you to go to KFC. And not just so you have absolutely horrible shits within 5 minutes of eating it.
Listen, I'm from India. That's happening anyways.
That's true, too.
Oh, I'm in India. What do you need? Toilet paper now.
Now, right now.
Now. Now. Leaves.
Right.
Take it.
Tea leaves?
Tea leaves. I mean, we're not sure.
My bum smells floral.
And itches.
Yeah, itches.
A lot.
Can't be good.
Can't see. Shit yourself. Go on.
Well, the shit yourself's just a bonus thing. It's not actually the story. So.
That's not a bonus.
Bonus shit!
We are going to encourage you to get the takeout box.
Okay.
Because built into the takeout boxes over there is a
trial. Oh, can I guess?
It's a porta potty.
You've already read the story, so.
I have.
It's a porta potty.
It's not really a guess. Nope, try again.
It's a porta potty.
Nope.
It's not a porta potty.
Okay.
Has to do with something useful in its technology.
Not very good, but yes.
A speaker.
No.
No. That would probably be better.
A fryer.
Why would it be better?
Because you didn't read the stats on it.
Oh. I don't know why they just didn't, like, use a wall outlet instead.
No.
A generator.
You're kind of close.
What anyways. Is it? Tell them.
It's a device charger.
Your box.
A USB device charger.
Yeah, it's a USB device charger. So basically you just take your thing and go. Thunk. Oh, hey. Hi, Deb. And everybody in Wyoming. Brad's there too. There's his hand.
Everybody in Wyoming.
Jazz well, that's hands.
That's where they are now.
Yeah. Oh. Deb is watching the Mouse of Lake.
We really don't know why, but... Deb's in Wyoming now.
I'm actually jealous because you're doing a national park tour. Jealous, goddammit. It's 2 hours true. Earlier there. Also jealous.
So.
Also.
It charges your phone.
Yes.
There's a USB charger built into the box.
But.
How about they save some money and just make my chicken a dollar cheaper?
Or not give you the shits.
I think that's kind of part and parcel of going to KFC.
No.
Isn't it?
No, that's added in the 90s.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Can it be recharged?
It can. But horribly.
You can recharge your
Go on, Jay, don't leave us in suspense.
Your clock a bucket can be recharged?
It can. But on the initial charge, it gave them 17% until it was completely drained.
Hey, that's better than nothing.
I guess. So is me rubbing a potato against my phone.
If you're sitting there...
I would be entertained by that.
But if you're sitting there and then you eat KFC, you're going to have to run to the bathroom.
Right.
And 17% battery life is not enough time for as much shitting as you're about to do.
Fair enough.
You need at least 25.
Yes, at least.
And then when they plugged it in to refresh it, they got 7%.
Wait, you can plug it in. You can plug in your box of chicken later.
Yes.
Retry and
which, by the way, this is built into like your box of chicken.
Yeah. So your little carry-out like takeout box.
Yeah.
So you'd have to So
I can see that like getting like drive through and like my phone dies or something like that, not having a charger. Like shit, where's that thing of chicken?
And knowing Brad, he'd have three of them in the back
seat.
Yeah.
Well, details.
I gotta look up this.
We are very unlikely to see it on American shores because they're just testing in India.
Yeah.
But you have to remember that other companies have done weird things, like Pizza Hut did a movie projector box.
I don't remember that.
Yeah, I didn't remember until they said it. I'm like, oh yeah, I do vaguely remember that.
I remember their BK video game
for
Xbox.
That was
a good idea, actually.
Kind of was. They did that in Hong Kong. KFC did the paper-thin Bluetooth keyboard in Germany, which we did a story about when that happened. And KFC also did chicken-flavored nail polish, if you remember that, in Hong Kong as well.
Yeah, that also sounds like a horrible idea.
It was. And then, of course, you had the fried chicken accessories in Japan.
Yeah, I saw.
It just looks like a red box with a plug and some lights.
Can you disassemble it to make an actual battery?
Probably.
If you really want to.
Or you get to spend $3 online and get something that's not
really
awful.
Can.
I spend $9 and it comes with a flashlight.
Yes. We're not talking about that. Anyways.
But it has so many attachments.
What else you got, Jay?
You want to field that one?
Nope.
Anyway. So we have talked.
I don't even want to be in the same freaking county, let alone the field.
You're probably.
Should we go back to Dex?
Nope.
Yeah. So we've talked about CRISPR in the past. I don't remember exactly what it stands
for. Okay, can I explain what CRISPR is real quick? Okay, CRISPR is essentially...
Something you put on cookies to make them crispier.
No.
Delicious.
It is...
Something that KFC uses to for their double-battered chicken breasts.
No, has nothing to do with food.
Okay.
Well, actually...
It keeps lettuce
well.
Crisper.
Well, no, I think it has to do with a...
keeping the soles of your shoes shiny.
No, I think it had to do with the bacteria E. coli or something. Anyways, but here's what it is.
It keeps your cufflinks nice and shiny so you look crisp.
CRISPR.
It does the highlights on your hair so that you look like you're frosted, like you're crispy.
Sucks when it's done to you, doesn't it?
It could technically be that if your genes were modified.
Okay.
So here's what it is.
So it works on genes, so CRISPR actually stiffens the bottoms of your jeans so that your bell bottoms flare out with style like the kids like to do these days.
Yes, that's it. So what CRISPR is...
It actually allows you...
so phenomenal to me.
This was so phenomenal.
You mimic a Superman cape, but only using a bath towel, and it stays in one spot, and then you can also use it on...
I don't want anything to do with a bath towel that doesn't move.
Oh, well, you know...
They just call that Scotch guarding, don't they?
No. That's one hell of a nickname for it, Jay. Anyways, what happened to that towel? Oh, don't touch it. I scotch-guarded that.
A lot.
You will thank me later.
Oh, man. Wow. All right. We are going to get so many lawsuits from Scotch.
Go on.
It's a good product.
No, okay. All right. Anyways, CRISPR
is what Carrot Top uses to keep his hair so red.
All right. No. CRIF. Fine.
That was a hate count it. Wow.
A howd it. CRISPR
is the acronym for the new Transformers movie. Transformers Revenge of the CRISPR. No? Rise of the CRISPR.
Starring CRISPR Glover.
The cracking of the CRISPR.
No.
No.
I have a CRISPR in my refrigerator.
Mine just freezes stuff.
Huh.
CRISPR... CRISPR
is actually what Tesla's using to charge new phones faster than a KFC box.
CRISPR
is only used in Mumbai by Subway to combat the Watt box.
CRISPR
is the Japanese ripoff of Pringles.
That's actually a decent one. I'll give you that.
That could be real. Hold on.
Japanese Pringles.
Looking. Ooh, they make a microchip CRISPR potato chip maker. Available on Amazon. 5 stars. That's pretty good. So what CRISPR actually is...
Is the nickname that Crispin Glover had in high school, and he hated it.
Yes?
I thought it was Crispy.
No, it was CRISPR.
Oh. What CRISPR actually is...
Was the first name that the Clippers were going to use for their basketball.
I'm just entertained, frankly. The Los Angeles CRISPers?
Yes. They decided to go with the Clippers.
Don't know why.
There were more hairstylists there.
Okay. Not the Clippers, though. Doesn't make any sense.
I don't know.
I guess.
Yeah.
I don't think that sound effects match. But what CRISPR actually is.
Is Frosty the Snowman's sidekick.
CRISPR
the sidekick.
He got left out of the stories. He fell through the ice and ran down the stream. CRISPR. Ta-da.
That was awful. Awful.
Sorry.
Come on, you can do... If you can come up with all those random things for CRISPR, you couldn't come up with one song for his, like, CRISPR the sidekick. He was a frozen buddy. He left in the sun too long. Now he's nobody.
Now he's soggy.
Now real soggy. See? See? What CRISPR actually is a gene...
tightening device that you use for low-rise genes because they're back at it again.
CRISPR is a gene editing tool used by scientists to modify genomic sequences. It basically can cut out little snippets of DNA, and then basically you flood that area with the little pieces you want to get inserted back into DNA, and it's basically an amazingly efficient way to modify a genome.
Also known as Brad's incredibly Scotch-guarded towel. It takes little clumpets of DNA and just puts them on a towel.
Is a clumpet a real
DNA
measure?
That is awful! That is awful! High five, you son of a bitch!
Yes!
All right. Tell us, Jay. Tell us about this
CRISPR.
Subway's combat of the Watt Box in Japan.
I don't know what the hell we're talking about anymore.
The CRISPR. I can do the story if you don't know.
He gave me like 15 varieties of it. I don't know what the hell's the real one.
We have to go back and do a count. But yes.
So a federal ethics and biosafety panel has actually finally approved for the first time human trials of the CRISPR-Cas9 gene editing technique.
So what they do is go... towel.
Wobble, 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 wobble,
no,
wobble.
No, they modify your T cells to fight cancer.
Yes.
So then they go... No, you won't get cancer. Right there.
Well, no. If you have cancer, then they take your T cells, and then they modify those T cells. They genomically modify them.
Genomically?
Yes.
Is that what it's really called?
Yeah.
That's cool.
Genomically, man. Genomically, whatever you want to call it.
So I have a much easier...
And they basically make those immune cells specifically target your cancer.
I have a much easier solution for this. You have cancer, take some of the Rock's blood, stick it in your body...
Is The Rock the new...
Cure for cancer? Yeah.
I was thinking Chuck Norris, but...
No.
CRISPR is The Rock's nickname.
No, he might be.
The Rock.
But Hugh Jackman could also
the
be.
The CRISPR
Hugh
Rock.
Hugh Jackman?
Hugh Jackman.
Hugh Jackman.
Could be the new Chuck Norris.
Yes.
I like it.
Who would you vote for president? The Rock, Chuck Norris, or... Assuming he's a U.S. citizen...
Santa
and
Claus.
Born in... In America, Jackie Chan.
Chuck Norris. He is the original. Anyone ever screwed with us, he'd just roundhouse kick the country.
Are we talking from a funny comedic standpoint, or are we talking from a serious standpoint?
Serious standpoint.
Probably The Rock.
What? How dull
really?
Is that?
Yeah.
Serious?
I was going to say Jackie Chan.
Well, he's born in Hong Kong, so...
Jackie Chan grew up in
Jackie
China.
Jackie Chan... Okay, Jackie Chan...
Unknown political stance. Chuck Norris, like, I'm pretty conservative, but Chuck Norris is batshit crazy. And The Rock is the only person I can think of.
I know The Rock is Samoan, but I don't know where he was born.
Hawaii.
We're assuming they're all citizens.
Why?
Let's just assume they were all born here. We're no birthers, so we're assuming everybody's...
Okay, Google.
He was born in Hawaii. Why don't you...
What is a CRISPR?
Oh.
Sorry for the... Adolescence.
You're so adamant about that. Dwayne The Rock Johnson, I believe, was born on Oahu. Where was Dwayne The Rock Johnson born?
Yeah, my voice isn't set up on this one.
Checking on that.
Thank you.
The birthplace of The Rock is Hayward, California.
Oh, California? How about that? Hayward, California.
Hmm.
Hayward,
Anyways, not in Hawaii. Lies. All lies.
But he is Samoan.
Yes. He's Californian, actually.
Okay, he has Samoan heritage.
Sure. Anyways, what else you got, Jay? Tech news.
The rest of that story?
Yeah, that.
So they just still need approval from the FDA, and the hospitals are actually going to be conducting the studies before they can actually start doing this stuff.
That is, it's awesome
science. On humans, yes.
It is, and imagine if that actually, like, works, like, ridiculously well.
That would
be amazing.
Awesome. Yeah.
Do you have an Apple TV?
Yes.
No.
Good.
What, you do?
I do.
Oh, I don't use it. What do I... How old is it?
It's the previous version.
Oh, okay. So it doesn't work with anything.
Sure it does.
Not well.
Is it? It's the one right before the Siri remote.
Okay. Can I have it?
No.
You can $5,000 for it.
No.
$10,000.
I can.
Why not?
It doesn't belong to me.
Who does it belong to?
Fork.
Work.
Details. Anyways.
NASA now has an app for Apple TV, so you can actually see the International Space Station in all of its gloriness. On your high def television.
You know what I'm going to do? I am actually going to set that up on work just to stream live.
What are you? So wait. What can you view now?
Like, they have these live cameras set up on the International Space Station that's pointed back at Earth. And as we were actually watching here last week, because you weren't here, you didn't see. Anyways,
sorry.
So I have a TV at my desk. Totally, you're just going to set that Apple TV up just to stream that.
Perfect use of work device.
It helps relax me so I am more productive at work. So, yes, it is.
You know, that's what I said about the flashlight, but they didn't let me keep it there.
No. Well, that was a flashlight, like first off.
It lit up.
I was trying to.
Sure
never
did.
Mind. I was trying to.
Subvert.
Even so now, on your Apple TV, if you get the NASA app, you can actually see high-def versions of NASA TV, on-demand NASA videos, 3D satellite tracking maps, and real-time views from the Earth from the ISS.
I like it.
So why can't you do that on a normal, like, say, a smart TV?
You can.
But now you can do it in high-def on Apple TV.
Well, hooray!
Why can't you do it in high-def on a smart TV?
Well, maybe you still can.
Maybe they don't have those apps yet for those TVs.
Maybe not, Pat.
Okay.
What if you have a Chromecast? We don't know. We don't know, but we know you can do it on an Apple TV, and that's new.
Also with the NASA app, you can queue up a slideshow of more than 15,000 images. You can stream the Third Rock Internet Radio, which I thought was a reference to the 90s, but is not. And you can view NASA's Earth as art galleries. What in the flying fuck is going on over here?
We just started doing it.
If you two are doing it, I don't want to be near you while you are.
Well, we were talking about decks earlier.
Talking about and actually doing are two different things.
Well, none of us have them, so. You have a patio.
I do have a patio.
Which means we have a place to put wood.
That's true. Mm-hmm. Look, everyone, Dig's here. Hi, Dig.
I need an adult.
Hi, everybody.
Yay.
There you go.
So.
I need a restraining order.
Yeah, you did.
And an adult. So the FAA has finally come out with final rules.
Part 107.
For UAVs.
Yay, drones. Here's the important part. For commercial operation of them.
Correct.
Yeah.
I was getting that.
So the one
My
you
first
have.
Sentence is going to be or for the commercial use.
Or if I decide
use.
To sell, do stuff commercially or whatever, yeah.
Yeah.
So eventually, you want to explain how you can get one? The commercial certificate?
Hold on. Let me ask it this way. Do you want to explain how to get one first?
No, go for it.
Okay.
So
first
how
of
you
all,
get one.
Yes. Go ahead, Pat. Explain the story. I'm calling you on your bluff. You better produce now.
Listen, when I interrupt, I actually know.
That's true.
Please read the story, Jay.
Well, tell us about
I wanted to hear
part 107, Pat.
Yes, please.
Or the tests.
Well, part 107 is that little wingy doodad that it makes the noise as it's flying. So that it's like a boat with the red and the red light and the green light, so you know which way it's going. Same thing that the drone has. If you didn't know that, you probably should. You own a drone. And it's actually part 107 is the noise amplification system that allows other drones to communicate with each other so they don't crash into each other. Duh. Thank
you. Jay?
Good, and you?
Good.
I don't know what you did to my mic, but I can't get back up.
I think your leg's on your mic.
No,
it just came unhooked.
Just like this show.
I'm like slowly getting pulled back. Oh, I can sit up again. Okay, so.
Part 107.
This is for any UAV under 55 pounds and flying for non-hobbyist purposes. They'll be subject to these regulations when they come into effect in August.
Yay.
So, somehow, some way. The FAA is expecting these rules to create 100,000 new jobs and generate $82 billion for the economy over the next decade.
Really? They actually came up with those numbers?
Yes.
For real?
Yes.
No.
I came up
with real quoted numbers.
Well, they're really
wrong.
Yeah.
Wrong. How many millions or billions?
82 billion. True statement.
For what? For a drone?
For 10 years. For UAVs, non-commercial.
The nice part is I can pretty much instantly get my license as soon as they come out with a thing because I have my pilot's license.
Oh.
Nailed
That's
it.
Cool. Let's see.
Are you going
to
get
so
one?
These rules are set up to integrate UAVs into existing airspace regulations, so everything airplanes have to do is basically you're
airplane.
A part of us now.
Yep.
Let's
Which
see.
Which makes sense. Can't go above like 12,000 feet or something like that.
400.
Planes can't fly that low.
Well, not planes. Drones.
If you're getting a pilot's license, you should You have to go 1,200 feet.
Well, you can go up to 18,000 with a class. Or a IFR.
How high can you go with your drone?
With my drone? Mm. How high? Like, until they have flown those satellite at Everest Base Camp, which is over 20,000 feet. It's pretty crazy.
How? Okay.
I'd never be able to get it up there because it'd run out of battery well before that.
Well, what's your range on your controller, too?
Line of sight, probably a couple miles. I could probably, like, theoretically, like, legitimately, I could probably, like, if I were just totally ignoring all rules and regulations, I could probably get it up to around 5,000 to 6,000 feet.
And then land it.
Said I could get it up there.
Never said anything about landing.
Yeah.
Okay.
So here's some of the rules for you.
Go on.
Under 55 pounds, you can only operate during the daylight hours or dusk if you have warning lights on it.
Yep. Up to 30 minutes of civil twilight.
I'm sorry. All I can picture is you, like, being in Iron Man 1 with your drone. Sometimes you got to run before you can walk. You take the thing straight up and just go.
Keep going and going.
And then all of a sudden you get so high where nothing seems to work anymore. You just go, and you just fall.
It doesn't fall out of the sky until the battery runs out.
Yeah. And then it falls out of the sky.
Yes, it does.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's going to be strict height limits.
Yep.
Of
400 feet.
And you're not allowed to fly over people
who are not involved in the operation of the aircraft.
But how are you, like...
You must be 16 years or older.
Yep. That rules you out.
And you have to hold a remote pilot certificate with a small UAS rating.
Yep.
Now, drones must be operated within the pilot's line of sight.
Is there another way to get that license without...
Pilot's license?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I hope it involves
background checks, and all I have to do is take a short quiz, and then I instantly get it.
Okay.
I've had more background checks done on me for work and
everything
else.
Doesn't matter. You still got to do it.
No, I don't care. You can do it all you want.
Basically, you got to pass a test, and then you got to do some background checks and some other stuff.
Well, what this means, because of these rules, is that a large potential of commercial applications, i.e. Amazon and their drone deliveries.
Not really. Line of sight thing.
They'd have to be like 500 feet up the road, just be like... Zzzz.
Yeah.
Yeah, still.
So if you can see a warehouse from your house and are too lazy to drive there, you're telling me there's a chance
for you to get your Twizzlers pack.
Yes.
But based on these, they're saying Amazon's idea for that, forbidden still.
So yeah. How much weight could a drone carry?
Depends on the weight of the drone, the power of the motor, size of the battery.
Like, okay, the one you have.
Maybe a pound or two.
Now... How much bigger do you think Amazon's drones would be?
Much. You'd have something like DJI spreading wings, like 800 or 1,000. You could have a payload of around 10 pounds. 10 to 15 pounds.
Ooh. I'm going to order a 10-pound bowling ball and see what happens.
No, they're going to deliver it via FedEx. A couple days later.
Yeah, but when they allow... When...
Meanwhile, Pat's house, 3 days later...
Build bowling balls.
Where's my bowling ball?
No, what I was thinking is like... If
FedEx guy shows up, take it back and drop it from a plane.
Climb on my roof and drop it down.
You're going to fly over Do it for me, delivery drone. Yeah.
And make a noise.
Whoosh. Spin around with your arms out.
have a malfunction and crash land.
Yeah.
What?
All right, Jay, what else you got? Are we still going on that?
He was pantomiming.
Evidently, a FedEx guy's dropping from the sky.
He was pantomiming the guy falling and watching him. It was very good, thank you.
Brain-like computers are now a reality.
I know.
But like real, like our brain.
I know.
Crazy.
People tell me my brain's like a computer.
Your brain is a computer.
Yeah, I know. I have to reboot it too often.
It's no Mac.
So what's the
error?
What's the
error,
biggest
error.
Reason?
Porn. No.
Ah, crap.
It's like everybody's everyday computer. Anyway,
gotta install the new pop-up.
Brain
blocker.
Crashed.
That's when we just bop him on the head a little bit. And
yeah.
What's one of the biggest reasons you've never seen a human-like computer? A human brain-like computer outside of a lab.
Because I can't afford it.
Because programming's really hard?
Nope.
Because I didn't know there was one.
That's a good reason, too. Power.
What about it?
Needs a lot of powder, Captain. Well, are you talking like a supercomputer with like a fake neural net and all that other garbage?
Just get a bunch of watts.
It's a freaking supercomputer.
KFC.
It takes thousands and thousands of watts.
It can get
megawatts
enough,
even.
It can get 1.21, if you might say.
Gigawatts?
Oh.
Actually, funny that you mentioned that number. We'll get to that in a second. So a real neuron up here in your canoodler uses 10 femtojoules.
Yep.
Which is an actual real unit of measurement.
Yes. What's it called again?
Femtojoules.
What was the other word you used today that I really liked?
Gigawatts.
Gigawatts?
No, the call about the shifter, splitter, CRISPR.
What about it?
The genome thing you were talking about, you used a word. What was that word?
CRISPR.
CRISPR.
No. It does something with the genealogy, but not genealogy.
So oh, genome.
Genomic.
Genomic. Cool word. And what'd you say?
Pat's trying to get vocabulary words.
You really
which
he
will misuse on Monday. Yep.
And mispronounced.
Did you hear about the genomic thing that happened over the weekend?
I don't understand what the hell is happening.
Yeah.
It's in part 107 of the CRISPR.
Yeah.
So a real neuron uses 10 femtojoules.
Femtojoules.
The That's new cool. version.
That's like 1/1,000,000th of a joule, right?
I'll get you the conversion in a second. So now researchers have built a nanowire synapsis that actually only consumes 1.23, not 1.21, but 1.23 femtojoules.
That's really good.
And a femtojoule.
How many do we fire?
10. This one basically uses a tenth of it.
Yep. Right.
A femtojoule is actually 10 to the negative 15th power. So.
Billionth. Trillionth?
Lots of zeros.
Millionth is 9. Wait. No. 7? Fuck. Anyways. Apparently I don't have enough femtojoules.
Or you have too many, it's just So what they've done is they've taken some organic material and wrapped them together to release and trap ions.
Well, negative would be 7.
I think I broke
million,
Brad.
10.
Keep going.
10 would be billion.
Just read.
13
so
trillion.
Scientists actually want to shrink their nanowires down from 200 nanometers, which is not that big to begin with.
Well, actually, that's huge when you're talking about transistors.
Yeah, thick down to just
a few. Intel's at like 14.
Yeah, so they didn't want to get it down to a few dozen.
Yeah.
And what they need is a new 3D printing technique in order to create these structures that closely imitate human brainage.
Sure.
So
right now, we use laser etching. Well, not etching. We use kind of a weird technique with focusing light beams and kind of
Good job. So anyway, what they're hoping is that once they get this down, they get the 3D printing, they're going to create a computer that has a human-like brain that they
I'm
can
a computer.
Use. Smarter robots, self-driving cars, stuff like that. They'll think more like us.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, it does that after about an hour, so it is what it is.
Oh, yeah. I don't like this.
What's that?
We're getting dangerously close to actually being able to produce artificial intelligence.
Sure.
And then what happens?
Robots just take over the world.
Yeah.
Then you don't need us anymore.
Then there's no more show.
Bummer.
What's going to be on a Friday night?
But computer versions of us can do it then.
Yeah, but they'll be better.
Yeah, that's right.
What would we do?
Stay home, play video games, and eat Chinese food.
Nailed it.
Oh, robot overlords for the win. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, see? Okay. That's what I'm saying. You say it's bad, but not really.
See, I don't see the positives in things sometimes. Thank you.
Move over, WebMD. Google's got your back now.
Go on.
You can now Google symptoms,
Google
they've
WebMD.
Improved their search for symptoms
good.
And what's causing stuff.
Good, because searching for symptoms on the internet has never made anyone paranoid about anything. Here. Doctor, I think I have gonorrhea syphilis.
I have a headache. It's slightly on the left temp. Oh my God, I have AIDS.
Yeah.
No. Watch this.
I thought I just needed some ibuprofen.
Hey, WebMD, I have a headache. No, well, you have cancer.
Yeah, you have a tumor.
Yeah.
My back hurts. You have cancer.
Everything's cancer.
Yep. I have a runny nose. Cancer.
I have a stuffed
infected?
Nose. What's that?
Yeah, I just got a paper cut on my finger. Like, definitely cancer.
Damn it.
There is no way it's not cancer.
Yep, totally that.
Everything on WebMD turns to cancer.
Pretty much.
How do you fix an ingrown hair?
WebMD. Cancer.
Oh.
I think I'm pregnant. Nope, cancer.
Yeah.
That's just a really big tumor that's going to grow over 9 months and it's going
to
get
smaller.
But the ultrasound says it's a baby. Like I said, cancer.
Cancer.
Oh.
See, I wasn't going to go that far. Even I wasn't going to go that far.
Darling bundles of cancer.
terrible.
Yep.
So now when you search for a symptom, it's going to show you a list of medical
cancer.
Conditions that could... Possibly be the cause.
Wait. Number one.
Wait. Say that again.
When you search for symptoms, Google will give you a list of
possible cancer.
It's just a list of cancer.
Yeah. The top, it's like the fill-in voice,
top,
you know?
Top 10 results show
cancer.
Damn it.
And number, cancer.
And number 11 is
cancer.
Damn it. Let me go down to 12.
AIDS. Cancer.
Shit.
Cancer AIDS.
I'm pretty sure that it's
just a stuffy nose.
Just, yeah, I'm pretty sure that it's not that. Let's go to number 15.
Cancer.
Damn it.
All right, we're going to go to number 1,943.4.
Herpes.
Yay, we got out of the cancer.
Slightly better.
I'll take that one.
Yeah.
So what it's going to do is going to serve some information alongside some self-treatment options that might keep you from having to go to your doctor. But
or cancer.
As always, Google reminds you that this is just strictly for informational purposes and that you should always go
no,
and see
no one with OCD
doctor.
Was ever harmed.
No.
There was a girl that I used to work next to, WebMD'd everything. She would and she would be getting like
my goldfish has a lump. That's its eyes.
Yeah. Well, she was she had like the runny nose and the headache, and she's like, I think I have something itis, and I was like, I'm pretty sure you got a cold. It's January. You might have the flu if it gets really bad. So eat some soup and have some vitamin C and call me in the morning.
Right.
She had a cold.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
But the cool thing about this, they actually did a review all these things with experts from Harvard Medical School.
Turns out they all had cancer.
And the mayonnaise clinic. So that was really cool.
The mayonnaise clinic.
Yeah. What would you call it?
Mayo.
So I said mayonnaise.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Go with that. Sure. Why not? Anyways.
What did I miss?
They nothing. Go by the, it's the street term that you like to use. Mayo.
Oh. I don't know. I just thought there was a thing. Have you been trying to think of a way to increase your cholesterol count?
No. I'm doing pretty good on that myself.
I don't have to think about that. That just comes naturally to me.
Well, bacon, I saw this story yeah. And I'm like, I want to do a food story.
Bacon?
So, Burger King has released the...
Bacon. Oh, well, there you go. There's your cholesterol.
Well, have released the Mac and Cheetos.
Oh, my snack. God.
What the fudge?
The Mac and Cheetos.
Go, please, explain to me. What is Mac and Cheetos? I think I know.
But, yeah.
But, please.
So, you know how they have their mozzarella sticks?
Yes. Wait,
basically wait. Take
by
out...
By the way, that's
a loose term.
A loose
term. A lot of breading.
A loose term followed by a loose stool. Right. But go on.
Yes.
And shitty marinara sauce.
Yeah.
So what they've done is they've taken the mozzarella, the very small amount of mozzarella, out of the stick, taken fried mac and cheese, and shoved it in the same casing. And then
wait, so
dusted it with the Cheetos
so it's,
cheese.
So it's in a the faux mozzarella... Like
it's the tubular. Breading.
The breading.
So it's mac and cheese breaded like a mozzarella stick, then coated in Cheetos dust.
Yes.
What?
Yeah.
They already gave Brad heartburn and indigestion.
Diarrhea.
So they have called it mac and Cheetos, and guess how much it costs for a 5-piece order?
$1.99.
$1.49.
Wrong direction.
Oh.
99 cents.
No, you're bouncing all around it, but you have
$1.49.
No, you already guessed that.
$2.99.
You're getting
$4.99.
No, not that much. $2.49.
Oh, well, it went cheaper, and you said wrong direct. Or wait, I went.
Well, you both said numbers at the same time. So.
Okay, so here's where we started, and here's where we went, and he said no, so then we went here, and then we went here, and then here, and then we did the walk like in a gym.
But guess what else you get with it?
Cancer.
Ranch dipping sauce.
Oh, my hand hurts.
Yeah.
That might
cancer. Cancer. Damn it. Yeah. Cancer high five? No. No, we can't do that. CRISPR high five.
Oh,
hurts.
Cure hurts.
Cure hurts. Man.
If you're looking for a new mobile game to play, boy, do I have the game for you.
Right.
It is called.
But he had the little eye bulge there too. It's like that's either like really yes or sarcastic.
It's a game where you play Donald
Trump. I might actually download this just to see how it goes. It's
does
called.
Does it involve cats?
No.
Involve cats?
No. It's still funny to hear it every time. It is called the Gordon Ramsay Dash game.
What?
It's where you run from Gordon Ramsay?
No. Actually, it's
where you buy Burger King and he just hurls insults at you.
It's actually like Hell's Kitchen, but in a video game form.
Okay.
And you can actually play against other
players. Are you sure it's not just him hurling insults at you?
You want to know the cool part?
He insults you?
He hurls insults at you in the game. So
it's awful.
You start out as a small restaurant owner. A
restaurateur, as you would.
Restaurateur.
An entrepreneur.
And...
Would that be an entrepreneur?
Yeah, sort of.
Sure. That's only if you want to be on The Bachelor.
A restaurateur.
If you want to be on The Bachelorette, you're always just, I like windsurfing, I like to do this, and I'm an entrepreneur.
Right.
That way it sounds good on the...
Yeah, entrepreneur.
Future pincushion, whatever.
I am the la.
The game comes out next week. And
you start out with this movies. What? What do you say?
What?
Huh? You turn the closed captioning on, says blah, 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 blah. That doesn't help.
You start out with a small restaurant,
mm-hmm.
and then you get things set up, and when you go to sleep, when you wake up, if you've lost business or you had like 5 Michelin stars and then you lose one,
mm-hmm.
he actually just starts yelling at you.
For losing 1 Michelin star.
Correct.
They're hard to get, you know.
They are very hard to get.
You know what else is actually pretty hard to get?
5 Michelin stars, because you can only get up to 3.
True.
In a restaurant, but anyways, yeah.
A dick fur. You don't want to know?
Dick for what?
Damn it! You were so close. Yeah. Never mind.
I tried to help. Sorry, I went off the road a little.
Have you heard that joke before?
Probably.
I know Brad has.
Go ahead, go for it. We're already here.
What's the dick fur?
Ta-da!
There you go.
I don't care if it's like from like when you're 5 years old. It's still funny. Oh, thank you, Brad.
You're welcome.
It worked on Brittany.
And we're not going to say anything beyond that. Our final story.
They showed her, so. You know, it's okay. It's okay. It's okay, guys. I showed her the deck.
She goes, I'm the one with the deck. Anyways.
I thought it was bigger.
So why does the Navy always say all hands on deck?
Oh. In the Navy.
In the Navy.
Yeah, that really doesn't make any sense because, like, then there's, like, everyone to the, like, is it everyone to, like, the surface level of the ship? Well, because they like, battle stations, it's, like, you know, that's different.
It's a ship or a boat, depending on the size or the class.
Oh, don't take a ship on your deck.
Anyway. Anyways.
That's a good advice to live by.
Boats or episode cruisers title. Or
don't take a ship on your deck.
Episode title.
Yeah.
They just rename everything anything they want, so you know.
Yes.
Port, aft, all that stuff. They made it up.
All right.
Deck.
Yeah. What else you got, Jay?
The Navy has the biggest deck.
And we're proud of
it. Or the Air Force. Would the Air Force have the biggest deck?
Yeah.
It depends on how you look at it. So anyway, our final story of the day is that we did this story how there's a fan film being done for Star Trek.
Yes.
Axel Foley or whatever.
Axnar.
Axnar, too. Yep.
So it's called Axnar. They did a GoFundMe or a...
Indiegogo,
whatever.
Something. And they get a lot of money.
They did a fundraiser. They raised over $1 million, and then Paramount and CBS
said,
oh, no, because you're making money to use
our
IP
property
and stuff.
Yeah.
So, Which the lawsuit's actually still going on. So, Pat has a question.
No, I don't have a question. I agree with the fact that they shouldn't make a profit if they're making a fan film, but I disagree with the fact that Paramount's being such a tool about it.
Yeah,
I can understand that because that's like saying,
it is their IP.
I'm going to make a new Star Trek, but it's just fan, but I can still make money off it. Well, no, because then you're infringing on their stuff.
It's like saying, I'm going to make a Halo movie, and all of a sudden it makes money, and I'm like, well, I made my movie.
Yeah, exactly. You're infringing on Bungie and 343 and Microsoft and all their stuff. If you're just saying, I'm taking my spare time and my own money just to make something for fans of the franchise, then it'd be like,
and then it'd be
cool. I think you can still, like, Here's the thing. I think you should still be able to raise money, that
to cover costs.
It almost has to be like Brewster's Millions. You ever watch that movie?
Yeah, you get so much money.
You get X amount of money. It has to be spent on it. You can't be left with any money at the end of this.
That's the part that got Paramount and CBS because the producer, director, creators, or whatever made money because they did everything. They said, "Oh look, there's money left over. Give me."
No, I don't want to watch that movie.
Yeah,
really good movie. In Brewster's Millions, he's given what?
You've never seen that?
No, movies scare me.
It stars Richard Pryor. Excellent movie.
Yeah, he's entitled to
a lot of gushing too.
He's entitled to $500 million estate or something.
But
he has to spend $33 million. And bear in mind, this was made in the late '80s.
'80s, yeah.
So
it was the premise of it, the beginning of the movie. I'm not ruining it. Is that the guy who was essentially left it to him? Had a movie or whatever, and said, my father caught me smoking a cigar when I was 5 years old. And he made me go in the closet and smoke the whole box. I'm going to make sure you get so sick of money you never want to see it again. So he basically gives him
$30 million.
The deal is this. You can either take $1 million and just walk, or you can say, here's, $30 million or $33 million or something like that.
And you
have to spend all of it and not receive any tangible assets.
That means you can't buy a house, cars, or anything.
Right.
So you can just buy stuff for people. Which, by the way, I could totally spend $33 million and not have a thing left.
Yeah.
Oh, in a heartbeat.
Brad,
you like Bentleys?
I love Bentleys.
Okay, you're gonna have a couple.
Fantastic.
Give me a list of your top 100 cars.
Fantastic.
And whatever houses you want.
Yep. So, anyways, that's the premise of the movie. What were we talking about again?
Star Trek.
Making money.
You can't be making a film to have, to essentially make money off of it. So that would be problematic if you were selling DVDs or something like that.
Yeah.
But you could go out and say, we're trying to raise money on this movie, and you can't necessarily promise anything in return.
I don't think it would be hard if you're selling DVDs or anything like that, because
here's the thing,
if you go through the actual publisher, saying, hey, I made this fan film, I would like to actually sell it. You have distributor rights on the IP.
They would have to agree to that.
Yeah,
what they were doing with the Indiegogo is they were essentially selling DVDs and Blu-rays ahead of time.
Yeah, it was like a Kickstarter. You get bonuses for giving money.
And I think the only way that works for fair use or something like that is you basically have to go hey, we want to make this fan film. Please, please contribute. That's basically how it goes.
Yep.
And you can't be left with any money. Yeah, and it's basically spend it all on the film.
Yep.
Yeah.
And there have been a ton of people who've done Star Trek fan stuff, never had
an issue. A lot.
Star Wars
they haven't
has
made
had
any money,
more
though.
Than
oh,
enough.
Oh, Star Wars has had a ton of great stuff. We've interviewed Star Wars Revelations or something like that. Uh-huh. We interviewed the guy on the show. Well, it was an amazing film. This was 7-8 years ago.
It was
incredibly well done. That was for a while. That was pretty big on the internet.
But I don't think he made any money doing it.
No, he didn't.
No.
So.
But when you have time and technology and
people getting together.
Talent.
There you go.
The three T's, time, technology, talent.
Details.
So CBS and Paramount said, to avoid this in the future.
Oh, God. And then
here are the guidelines.
They just dug themselves a freaking hole.
Yep.
Here are the guidelines that you have to meet to govern fan-made Star
please,
Trek
go.
Productions.
Wait, wait, wait.
So who came up with this?
CBS and Paramount.
Oh,
themselves.
Good. Yeah.
What's
good.
Number one?
And they're $1,500 an hour lawyers, I'm sure.
Number one.
Don't use any of our IPs.
Their creativity limited to less than 15 minutes for a self-contained story, quote unquote, or no more than 30 minutes for a truly epic two-parter.
To that I say, go F yourself. Number two.
No sequels or additional seasons are allowed.
To that I say, go F yourself. Yep. Number three.
Let's see. Material must be family-friendly, quote unquote. And cannot include profanity, nudity, obscenity, pornography, depictions of drugs, alcohol, tobacco, or any harmful or illegal activity.
I understand what they're saying. Does not fall in that. What they're asking still doesn't fall under fair use. So go F yourself.
And plus, if you've ever watched an episode of Star Trek, none of that would apply anyhow.
Ever.
Except the naked now because Data got laid.
Yeah.
What?
He did. He banged Tasha.
Well,
good for him. She could have been so pretty, but they made her look so ugly.
So the robot is the only one who got action.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
Or on top of what I just stated,
uh-huh.
anything else that can hurt the brand.
You can't do something that would libel or essentially injure the brand. That I get.
So Captain Picard can't teabag Han Solo.
Right. Okay. That you could basically say in, you know, potentially could injure the image of the brand.
Yeah.
Yeah. That I get.
Yeah.
That I say okay.
But if I make a
Brad's okay with that.
Yeah.
But if I make a 17-minute decent.
But if
film,
it involves drugs or something like that,
it's not a Star Trek thing.
It doesn't. Yeah. That's.
But now is this for any of their IPs?
No, this is just for
Star Trek.
Oh, good. I can't.
They don't have anything else. What
else you got, Jay?
Your fundraising is limited to.
Okay. Uh-huh.
Guess how much?
5,000.
I was gonna go as a high 500,000, but I'm gonna go 20,000. 20,000, reasonable guess.
Add another zero to yours.
50,000.
Correct. Your fundraising is limited to 50,000, so basically you can buy.
So that I say go F yourself. But that being said, for most people making, you know, whatever, that's still stupid.
Yeah, basically you can buy film stock and maybe a LED light.
Shoot, not film. What are you, Tarantino?
Yes. Okay, Brad, I don't know if you know this off the top of your head. Do you know how much it would cost to rent one of the Sony Red cameras?
They're not made by Sony. I mean, so either the Sony Cine Alta or the Red, like Red Epic or Red,
sorry, the Red,
Red
Epic.
Dragon
Red
Weapon.
Yeah.
Probably around $1,000 a day. Plus lenses. Okay. So I'd probably end up spending around with the prime lens I need around $2,200 a day. And actually, I can let you know.
No. Is that for one, like $1,000?
Yeah.
Doesn't have to be accurate. So if you wanted actually,
except for, OCD.
So you can blow your money on cameras.
Oh, easily.
Oh yeah.
And have a 20-day shoot.
I don't know why, because I have a 1080p 60 frame camera right here, or a 4K camera right here.
I'm pretty sure those cameras are a little better.
All you need is a cool little gimbaly
thing
like
Brad
has, and you can go like this, and it'll be perfectly smooth.
No.
Not including all of the lenses and all the other bullshit I'd have to rent.
Scheiße. Just the body.
All right, so if I were doing renting a
stock lens.
All right, so say I'm renting a Red Epic X Dragon, just the body, no monitors or anything else, it would cost me a little under $200 a day.
That's not horrible.
Maybe you have to also
and then lens. You also need the hard drives, the mounts, the lenses. I'm probably spending around $600 to $1,000 a day.
It's $3,000
for
round numbers.
So if you want two actual angles, which you'd want at least two.
No, not necessarily. No, because usually when you're filming, you're doing multiple takes. You know, the only time you have multiple cameras is if you have something that's what we're going to call like expendable, like explosions or things like, you know, things of that nature where it's really expensive to do the actual, you know, action itself, in which case you do multiple camera angles at that point. But most of the times you're shooting your far, your medium, your close up, and you're doing like eight takes per thing. It's a lot of saying the same lines over and over again.
I don't want to be an actor.
No?
No.
No.
Want to be a contender?
No.
Could have been a contender. Sometimes you get a director who does more interesting stuff.
I'll be a best boy.
But most of you're gonna help with lighting, anyways.
You help the key grip.
Yeah,
can I do key grip?
Sure.
Can I be a?
You don't even know what a key grip is.
They set up lights.
Yes. Bethel helps the key.
That's the only reason I know why that is what it is. Yep, you grip the key.
Well
Yay
done.
For you.
Well done. All right, what else?
But wait, there's still two more things that we need to do before we can even think about making our Star Trek episode.
What?
By the way, you can't use any Star Trek stuff.
You can't.
None of the licensed material.
Well, you know, actually, it's funny you say that,
you know,
because
funny you
guess
say
what
that.
The next one is.
You may only use...
Filmmakers are only allowed to use officially licensed merchandise, quote, and not bootleg items or imitations, unquote, as props and set pieces.
To that I say go F yourself.
Yep.
So you actually have to go to Paramount Studios and
you
go into their
buy
storage.
Our stuff. No!
And you have to actually go get the real
kidding?
Captain Kirk chair out of storage and use that on your set.
Okay.
F yourself.
I need to make a replica. What was it, a deck? What is it? What is it?
Holodeck?
Bridge. The bridge.
The bridge, thank you.
Engine bridge.
And how much do you think that's going to cost to get all that out of storage?
More than 50,000.
Yeah. Oh. Okay, go fuck yourself.
So they're making
it. You won't say it, I'll say it. I have no censor.
And finally, hold on, let me make sure I say this correctly. So if you can make it through all those hoops.
And you can't.
Which you can't. With the spending restrictions and everything else, you also have to distance yourself from the official productions with an obligatory disclaimer in the movie.
Is that cut into the 15 minutes?
Probably.
or 30-minute two-part.
And it has to be in plain font face. Like, it has to be, like, they have restrictions on, like, the title, too. It's like, blah, 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 requires to say fan film at the end. A fan film production in plain typeface.
Wait.
Like, seriously? No. No. Go F yourself.
No. Here's a question.
I can see them basically requiring at some point in the thing to basically say, like, not if, you know, you want to say not affiliated with CBS, Paramount, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, right. Blah, 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 blah.
Which is fine, but
that you should have to have in there somewhere. I get it. But it's like, they're like, you have to use this font face and it has to say this exact wording, blah, 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 blah. It's like, seriously? No. Go F yourself.
What if you do it in Klingon?
Ha!
It's their language.
Yep.
Paramount owns...
Yeah, they addressed that.
Did they?
Yeah, you can't use... The language is copyrighted.
Has to be in English.
Which is...
All this stuff is copyrighted!
Well, that's actually going to real courts and real cases because it involved Google about copyrighting a language. There's some dispute about whether you can copyright a language.
Which I don't see how you can.
No.
That's like, I'm going to go to court and say I'm going to copyright English.
I see a lot of Star Wars, a lot more Star Wars.
I just discovered how we're going to make our millions!
Yes! Copywriting, no, actually.
Listen, the patent office never paid any attention to prior art before. Why would they now?
That's true. Actually, let's do English and Spanish because it's the two highest spoken around here.
can we
just send in a patent application and send them an unabridged dictionary and write out, like... Cross out Webster and write Jay and Brad and Cran.
Hey, what about me?
Absolutely.
Listen, you had your chance.
Oh.
You wanted Italian. We wanted English and Spanish. So
yep.
Wait, so you get English, you get Spanish, and I get Italian?
See.
Piss.
Well.
That's Italian for...
That's actually British, piss. But yes.
We.
English.
It's my language.
So there's your tech news, and we got 3 minutes to go, kids.
So let's do the promos. If you missed any part of this show, and it was a good show. If you missed any part of it, you want to catch it.
See you in 90 minutes.
You mean 93 minutes?
Give or take.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah,
93 minutes. We'll be out again at midnight on this very channel following neighborhood news and meet the leaders or meet the Robinsons or meet Jeff Siner
or
say
meet
funny things to someone
quasi-locally
important.
But Brad,
what
if they can't watch it at midnight but they want to watch it again?
YouTube.com/NSLSTV.
What if they'd like to get a hold of us though, Brad?
NSLSTV@gmail.com.
Any other social medias that we have?
Facebook.com/NSLSTV and Twitter.com/NSLSTV. All right.
Brad.
Yeah?
What did you learn today?
I learned that really no one has as big a deck as they would really like. I mean, honestly, when it comes down to it, you know, having a bigger deck than everyone else is really just
deck envy.
It's deck envy. It's really what a lot of people are envious of. Yeah.
I mean, you could have a double decker too.
I thought that's when you crap in the top bowl, but all right.
I was gonna go.
Oh, that's an upper decker.
That's an upper decker.
Yeah, sorry, my bad. Pat, what did you learn today?
That I forgot what an upper decker was for a minute.
You're like, what's a double decker? I think we just invented something new.
Copywritten.
Oh, wait, that's when you crap in the top bowl and then on top of the thing that goes on top of the bowl. That's a double decker.
There's poop there. Oh.
Somewhere there's gonna be a college student that does that and be like, I learned that on the Not So Late Show. And then someone's gonna be like, those sons of bitches. Who are they?
Hey, it's you're that guy. You're that other guy.
Yeah, the other guy. The other guy from the other guy. Jay? What'd you learn today?
Don't ship on your deck.
Don't ship on your deck.
Yes, don't ship on your deck.
Don't ship on your
deck. Don't ship on your deck.
If I can give you any advice in the world, don't get a ship on your deck.
Yes.
Is that why they call it the poop deck?
No.
No more.
I don't know how much time's left in the show.
How much what? don't know. I mean, somebody in the back might be.
How much time we got, Doug?
30 seconds.
Oh my God!
How we just filled an hour and 29 minutes and 27 seconds. How are we gonna fill another 23 seconds after this, Pat?
Awkwardly staring at the camera.
Do we have a show next week?
Do we have a show next week?
Why wouldn't we?
Because July 4th. Just saying.